Sup guys, Hobo Samurai here, and today we'll be discussing the Z-Alloys, so let's get started. First thing I recommend doing is taking off all of your alloys off every character, stripping them of everything. Then I want you to go in and right here, we should be buying your alloys that you plan on purchasing today. I am going to purchase a 50 here real quick for you guys. Alright, we got a purple, two purples, some green, blues, golds, grays. Okay, now I'm going to call it good for that. Now, I believe this game's mechanics work best in the sense of not having one overpowered guy and the rest kind of being okay, but more balanced. So, I recommend, and this is what I do too, is taking your best alloys and putting them on your weakest character for your main team. The last thing you want is to ever go up against a 1v6. You're never going to win that way. So, I'm going to quickly drop off all my alloys on my page real quick here. Whoops, that's not how we do it. We can do the quick remove. I'm just going to remove them all off. And you should do that on everyone. Then find your weakest character, like I said before. And we're going to start there, and you work your way down the list to your strongest character, getting the weakest alloys, creating the best balance you possibly can. Now, once when you have all of these in place, quick set, and I recommend using the quick set. It just seems to automatically pick the best stuff for your character, in case you guys didn't know that. I will go through here, quick set, and accept. There we go. Our alloys are done now. Now you want to level them up together and evenly. And there's a little bit of customization that we can do with this as well. First thing I want to talk about is I am running Goku Black. I try to use him more offensively, and the auras are all based on the shapes, not the quality. So we can do some interchanging here. So let's see what we can do. This looks like a lot of attack. Let's see if I could change this defense HP one into something, into another attack. Do I have one? Let's see. I do, but it's not a level 50, so I think I might just hold off on that. Okay. Nothing for here. Attack, attack, attack. This is what we're looking for, guys. I want to make him as much attack power as possible. Alright, so the round sphere, can we change that one to something that's not... Okay, we can. So I have an attack HP one here for 50. I am going to swap it out with the red, as the red one is currently not leveled up, and my aura does not change. Remember that, guys. It's all based on the shapes. Another little thing that you could do too, for example, you see up here at the top, where's my mouse? Normally, in the same quality as these gems, for example, a gold and a gold or a red and red, you cannot have the same two types. But if they're of different quality, you can stack them. So if I really wanted to get crazy, and this, for example, using the square here, if this was the same, I could use a purple version of it and have attack, defense, attack, defense, attack, defense, so on and so forth. And you can do this on every page as well. So I'm just going through and doing this, doing that with... All right, a lot of defense here. Let's see if I can swap some of this out for attack. Oh, that's all defense. Nothing there. Alrighty, here's an attack defense, but it is quite... So I'm going to have to level those up. I will pass on that. And the same thing, I don't have any more that are really leveled. So if this was within 10 levels or so, I would, but level 50s at this quality, very expensive. So some I'm going to have to work on later. So another thing that I want to address with the Z-Alloy system is that when you place your Z alloys together, I did it earlier, you want to start with the one that has the most gems. because that's going to give you the bigger aura. And then you go from there. So for me, it's the advanced auras. Then I drop down to medium and place the best one I can there, and then the basic, and you guys should do the same. And for some of you that are still leveling, let's say in here, for example, if, can I just take this off? Yes, I can. Some of you guys might only be able to acquire an aura, for example, and your page would look like this, and you can only place aura. So I have no aura active, but let's say I'll just scroll down. I'll put on a weaker aura to show you guys. So boom, I now have an aura active. But let's say you're in that weird, awkward in-between stage where you have some open, you can add and it won't affect the aura. So I can go into change here and just throw this guy in. For example, if I had one extra spot and my praise aura still remains. And I think the last thing I want to touch on this video, I'm going to set this back real quick. I'll do a quick remove. Whenever you go to set an aura, guys, do a quick remove, because it's going to replace those, your best ones that were on there, and it won't detect them and re-add them. So remove them, put all my best ones back on there where it goes, and we are set. So if you're ever hurting for gold or the debris, okay, so you can scroll down, and I'm save this guy as an example. Where is he at, Gotenks? There he is, past him. Go once again to the page that has the most open for you to use. And then you can quickly go into quick set. And I recommend you do this on every character and get all the claim bonuses. Start at the bottom, do the ambition aura. See how my aura list has highlighted? Then quick remove, quick set. Do it again. Quick set, do it again. And we're just gonna keep doing this. 2, 3. We're on this one, the devotion. And we are going to get the claims on all of this. The abyss. Confident. Terror, and then spirituality. Now I can go into my aura lists, hit the quick claim, and there it is. I recommend doing this literally on every character. It is very time consuming, but by the time you go through all this, you'll have a good chunk of gold and a good portion of alloy shards that'll have you ready to rock and roll and start leveling these up for your main six in your team. And speaking of leveling up, I see a lot in the Facebook chat asking about Z alloys. And guys, even if it's a great quality, level it up. When you decompose an alloy, you will always get 100% back your gold and your shards. So do not miss out on an aura simply because you don't want to use a gray or a green and you're waiting for purples and stuff. Use them all, level them up, and then as you get better quality, you can decompose them to re-level and you won't be out anything. There is no point in sitting there not having your team optimized, I guess would be the word. So, quick remove. Well guys, I believe that is it. Thanks for watching. Peace.